Thank him for his love that has kept you thus far, of which has silenced the works of the enemy. Just find a word to say thank you, my Father, for all you have been doing for me. Thank you for all the provision you are giving to me thus far. Thank you for your love. Thank you for who you are. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you for you and the great I am that I am. We bless your name, O God. We give you all the glory. Now ask of the Lord tonight to speak to you. Say, Father, I know you love me. I know you are my God, you are my strength. Send forth your word to me tonight. Your word says, send forth your word that will heal and deliver them from their destruction. Send forth your word to me that will deliver me from any destruction ahead of me. And when you send forth your word, Father, help me to abide with that word. All to your glory, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. And so, Father, we thank you tonight. We bless your name. We give you all praise, honor, and adoration because you are the Lord. Tonight, Father, we ask of you to speak to us. Teach us your word and let it come into understanding to your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Welcome everybody tonight to another Bible study, through which we believe that heavens we give us another understanding of his word, in Jesus' name. Amen. Tonight, what you have ahead of us, or to share together, or to learn together, is what you titled the power of attraction. The power of what?
Attraction.
Many children of God are ignorant of this. But unfortunately, every creation has this seed in you. And part of those people who knows this, mostly, is the devil. And let me say, his children are the demons that walk with him. They know that there's something we call the seed of power of attraction. It works negatively, and at times it works positively. But many of us are not conscious of it. That's why many are prey to the kingdom of darkness today, because they come in or they operate in that area. No matter how small, no matter how old, no matter how big, no matter how titled you are, you have that seed, the power of attraction. But now the control of whether attracting positive or negatively is what now lies in your hand, or in the power that controls you. And I pray God will give us understanding in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Genesis chapter 3 from verse 1 to 6. Genesis chapter 3 from verse 1 to 6. Now the serpent was more crafty than any other beast of the field that the Lord God has made. And he said unto this woman, yea, as God said, ye shall not eat of every tree of the garden. And the woman said unto the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden. But of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God has said, ye shall not eat of it, neither shall you touch it, lest you die. And the serpent said unto the woman, ye shall not surely die. And see verse 5. For God doth know that in the day that ye eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened, and ye shall be as God, knowing good and evil. Verse 6. And the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was pleasant to the eyes, and a tree to be desired to make one wise. So she took of the food thereof and did eat, and gave also unto her husband with her, and he did eat also. Tonight, where it lies, where the power of attraction started working against her, is not from beginning. From beginning, the devil was still trying to play a tricky game. Did God say we should not eat from this thing? Well, she's still saying no. God just said we should not eat of just one particular tree, and they were still talking. But the moment the power of the darkness triggered the power of attraction in her, her eyes now went straight to see that fruit in a different way. She has been seeing that fruit every day before now. So likewise, when you see a man that fall at times, the same girl that they've been seeing every day, that they are not moved with it, but that day when they will trigger the power of attraction negatively, you just see, wow, this girl has been here in this office for a while. I never noticed she's so beautiful like this. That thought you started coming forth. I mean, if you ask her, or ask him, sorry, who tell you they've been together for a while? Why this time around? Eve has been living with this fruit for a while before the devil came. She has been passing by that tree or that fruit for a while. But that power of attraction on the negative side was not triggered then. So she just went by and not noticed it. But the day it came, it was triggered at that moment when the devil was talking to her. And because she was triggered, she has no refusing power anymore. I'm praying over everyone here today. Whenever the enemy tried to trigger anything against us, the power from on high will make it impossible.
Amen.
I said the power from on high will make it impossible.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The power of attraction. When it comes upon a man, or when it's triggered on a man, it can be channeled towards positive things or negative things. For Eve, this was channeled towards a negative thing. And we look more of people who negatively were affected through this. Fortunately, today we read in the open level the story of Samson. And if we read Judges chapter 14, from verse 1 to 3, you get to a point where Samson could not resist what he was seeing anymore. Judges chapter 14, from verse 1 to 3. And Samson went down to Timnah and saw a woman in Timnah of the daughters of the Philistines. And see verse 2 and 3. And it came to pass, he told his father and his mother and said, I have seen a woman in Timnah of the daughters of the Philistines. Now therefore get her for me to a wife. To wife. And then his father and his mother said unto him, is there never a woman among the daughters of thy brethren and among all my people that thou goest to take a wife from the uncircumcised Philistine? And Samson said unto his father, get her for me, for she pleases me well. And you know what? That moment, that power has been triggered, and he has no resisting force to resist. Not knowing that this same thing that pleases him will be the channel, a weapon to be used to destroy him. A weapon that will be used to make his life to be cut short. Because if you get to know the story of Samson very well, he died at a point in time when he ought not to have died. Because if you then look at it so much, you know that the attraction, the power of attraction that has negatively affected him, captured him so much that I want to say love at that moment from Samson was done. A woman asks you, tell me the secret of your power. You say, oh, you didn't buy me with chain. And she took chain and buy you and called the Philistine. And you arose, you broke it. You say, oh, you told me lies. If you love me, honey, suit me, honey, tell me the secret of your power. He said, oh, if you can tie me with a twin that is wet. And the woman did. I said, oh, the Philistines are here. He looked up again and destroyed it. He said, well, have you lied to me? You say you love me. Is that not done? The third time. He said, tell me the truth now, if you know you love me. He said, oh, okay. If you use a string that's never been used, and the man get one quickly, tie it around him, and he whistled, the Philistines are here. And Samson rose up again and destroyed. The man said, why have you lied to me three times when you say you love me? You know what's called love? Love is love. And maybe that time he started rubbing in the back of his neck. You know, I was joking with a guy that was some time ago. He used to work under me that time. And he came to work one morning, very troubled. He could not even walk, his performance was very low. I mean, he could not walk rightly. And out of curiosity, I just said, what's wrong with you? Are you okay? You know, send me to the doctor? I said, no, I'm okay. What's wrong with you? He could not smile, he could not eat. Later, I took him out. Something's bothering you, tell me. And I said, it's my wife. What happened? He said, you know, you remember I told you before that the 2 kids we have are not my kids. I married her when she already had 2 kids. I said, yeah, I remember. He said, then we have misunderstanding for 2 months, and I left the house. So when I came back, and some few weeks later, no, after I came back, about a month or so, she became pregnant. And yesterday, we went to the doctor, and the doctor says she's 3 months pregnant. And I didn't even catch it right, but when we are going home, I now felt 3 months, I'm not home 3 months ago. So I now ask her, what happened? 3 months I'm not home. He said, hey, if you are not home, do you expect me to keep myself like that? If you want to stay, you stay. If you want to leave, you leave. So he said he left. And he felt cheated somehow. I said, well, the first 2 you are taking care of are not yours. She just helped you to add the 3rd one. He said, Mike, what are you saying? I said, no. I said, the only way she will not add the 3rd one successfully is that if you avoid that rubbing the back of your neck. She just take it as a joke. So some days after, I saw him happy and I said, hey, what's going on? He said, man, she rubbed the back of my neck. I'm back home now. So we are be taking care of the 3rd child that is not his. Why? I said, why? He said, I just love this girl. The 3rd child that is not his. The power of attraction has been used against him. So Samson, when they asked him, this 3rd time you have told me lies. Why did you choose to do this to me? And Samson said, okay, I know I love you. I will tell you the truth. No razor should touch my head. Not give her the whole secret. And she find a good... The Bible says, and she pet him to sleep. Why she was petting him to sleep? Where? On her lap. Where somebody, a man is resting on you, where are you going to rub? You rub, I mean, you see, I'm talking. Rubbing the back of his neck and made him to sleep. I cut off that hair and now called the Philistine to come and they capture him. And the first thing to do is to take out his eyes. And that bring the life of Samson. That cut his life can be short. But that was not the beginning. The beginning is when the power of negative attraction came upon him. And he has no resisting power. He has no resisting element to resist or reject it or refuse it. He let it settle on him. And he became a life shorter. I'm praying up of everyone this night that any weapon or sword against any here will not have dominion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I say will not have dominion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It can come in any form. It can come in any form. To Esau, the reason why Esau lost his own birthright is about what? It's about food. Because when he came, the attraction of that food, when he heard the smell and he said, oh wow, give me porridge to eat. And the brother was just joking. What are you going to give me if I give you my porridge? I don't care anything you want. Okay, what about birthright? I don't care about birthright. Take my birthright. Do you think that is ordinary? That's not ordinary. Something is working inside. In Africa, we call that remote control. They have remote controlled him that he is no more of his senses. Take my birthright. I don't care. For a meal, more than 5 minutes, or less than 5 minutes at times. If you eat it standing, less than 5 minutes, it will have been done. And he just gave his birthright. That's no more ordinary. That came upon him so much that, and that's how it do happen to some. That when you lost after some things like this, you forget the consequence. You forget what's going to come about it. You forget what's going to come around it. You even forget what will be the end result. All I want it now. And some of us don't know, because when we know, that there's this kind of thing that the devil do trigger at times that cut our destiny short or that change our future. We're very cautious when we are sensing anything of such. We'll be able to say, let me check, am I okay? Is this the man pushing? Is he okay? For anybody, somebody was making a joke one day. He said, even though they are saying, America, Nigeria, he said, carry a flight, an aircraft to Nigeria, park it somewhere, and put a kind of big label, big banner on it. Say, this flight will take, this aircraft will take you to America, but you're going to be a slave for 10 years. He said, you will see the man calling his wife, if you are not going, give me Sule. Sule, come. Your mom is not going. Because they felt attracted to the United States, feeling that the place is a land of milk and honey. No, they call it a land that's flowing with money. That you pluck money on the street. If you tell someone, they will tell you, why are you there? If it's not as easy. A man was praying for his son one day. No, they invited him. Somebody was going to abroad, one of his own relation. He now saying, as has not been easy for Samson, it will not be easy for you over there. He said, you are cursing him. He said, no. He said, because this boy that is there, anytime we are talking to him, say, Baba, it's not easy here. It's not easy. And the boy is making it. So, as it's not easy for him over there, it won't be easy for you when you get there. He's praying for him. Because the boy was always telling them the truth that it's not easy. Don't think I'm sending you money. I'm just telling you, it's not easy here. But once the man get any tip of the money he sends, he felt, oh, it's not easy that you are sending money like this. Okay, it won't be easy for these ones too. So that power of attraction, the devil knew that everyone has it. Guess what? Have you ever imagined? They want to advertise a car on the TV. In most times, who do you see they use? They use a woman or a girl. You see some calendar everywhere advertising a tool that a girl does not even make use of. But they put the picture of a half-naked girl. Because they know that when a man, that seed is being triggered, sees that picture, he will start to read. It was the picture that will attract the guy before he now sees the tool that tried to advertise. They know if they just put the tool there, he might not stop to look at it. That's why they just put that kind of picture. And even the news in the TV too, they just print a kind of picture. You will see what they used to attract you first. It's only Geico that knows difference. They will just put a kind of crazy thing. At least it will make you turn your face to say, oh, what's this? What? They know. It's also attraction. If you just say, oh, Geico insurance, you might walk out of the room. But if you first see, well, let's say a Geico, a lizard walking, you will start to see lizard walking. It's correct what they are showing. They show kind of a stickers on the car. I don't even know what the one they are showing now. The stickers on the car that shows an animal. Say, what sticker? Don't you know the kind of thing we have placed upon in this car we have been on for 5 years? That will make you listen. The power of attraction. The trigger to divert your attention. To change your mind. To have a tough steel. To have it's tough for a moment. And I pray today that every negative for such that have been set into place against us in the future, it will stand no more.
Amen.
I say it will stand no more.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
But also, God put that seed in us for good things. God put that seed in us for good things that it will help us to achieve greater things. It will help us to get to where we need to get to. It will help us to know the good from the bad. But the devil knew that and he was taking advantage of it. Because the same thing that's in us is what made Abraham to become fruitful, to become settled in the fruitfulness that God has declared for him. In Genesis chapter 18, from verse 1, the Bible declared that Abraham was seated under the tree, and he saw three men going by. That power of attraction in him just was triggered, and he saw them. Three men. I need to invite this one's home. He was attracted to them. And he beckoned on them. He met with them and pleaded, please, I know you are sojourners. Can you just stop a moment? Let me give you water to drink, and so you can also wash your feet. And they said, okay, do as you have said. And at the end of the day, He asked them again, I don't want to give you only water to drink. Can you permit me to make a kind of little cake and bread or whatever to add to it? They said, do as you have said. And he did. Not knowing that they are the destiny carrier that will make his fruitfulness to come to pass. After they have ate and satisfied, I believe when they have their children, call your wife. Where is the syrup? At the back. In verse 14, that now said, oh, it was verse 14, but now says, then it is too difficult for the Lord. The now said, by this time next year, Anna will be with his son. I said, I will be with his son. And the husband started laughing. They were like, what are you talking about? Why is your wife laughing? He said, I'm not laughing. But the truth is that the beginning of that thing came with that power of attraction. Was attracted to them when they were passing by. Can you just imagine it? How many people would have, those people that passed by, if that power is, then the star seed is not triggered, how many people would they have passed by that they would not have known that these are destiny carriers? They just go by, they wouldn't know, they didn't see anything to them. And at the same time, some will even curse them because they don't know. And the same format also happened to the Shunammite woman in the book of 2 Kings chapter 4, verse 8. The Bible recorded it that Elijah was just going by on the street. And this woman saw her, and something in this woman knew. So I need to get close to this man. And she ran and stopped the man of God and said, please, can you come in and eat? The question there is that, how many houses do you think Elisha will have passed by that nobody cares? Nobody cares. But something in her was triggered. I'll share with some of you here. The greatest time in my life that things started changing was when I just felt, again, there's an elderly man, all gray hair, and something in me just attracted me to him to say, okay, you know what? Buy something for this man. And I went to what we call, I went to this mall, I went to the mall to buy what we call provision in Nigeria. Some of you know what's called provision. And I just took it to him. When I took it to him, it was in the hallway. He opened it and saw sugar, see Milo, see milk. He said, Mike, you brought sweet things to me. Kneel down, let me pray for you. And I knelt down. When he started praying for me, even while I was still kneeling down, I knew this is not ordinary. This is not just an ordinary prayer. And the outcome of it started when I now said the chairman of our local government, whom I never met at all, my brother was one that relate with him, that work with him, that have this boss he wanted to serve. He didn't offer my brother. He asked my brother, you have been talking about your junior brother. Ask him whether I want to buy this van. And my brother came back home and said, oh, the chairman said whether you want to buy his commercial vehicle. I said, yeah, tell him I'm interested. So he went again and said, he should come and ask me how much I can pay. I said, go and ask him how much you want to sell it. We're now selling, I mean, and the man is a big man. He said, I mean, you know, in Nigeria is a chairman of a local government. You know how they are? All those kind of ones that wear white and, you know, they are driver, I mean. My brother come back again and say, no, he said I should tell him how much I want to pay. So I was now telling my brother, let me see the vehicle first. Let me see the vehicle. I mean, can you imagine how old was I then? And they brought the vehicle for me to sit. I said, go and tell him I can't pay more than 10,000 and I'm not paying once. And my brother went and tell him. The second day came back again and said, pay with whatever you want to pay. I said, yeah. I said, this is not becoming not ordinary. And I check around then, all I have on me, I think it was about 2,500 I have on me. I want to buy something for 10,000. I said, go and tell him again, I'm not paying at once. He said, yes. He said, who say they should give me the vehicle and pay whenever I like. Ah, my mind just went straight to the prayer that I was attracted to the other day. And why I then know it's not natural, it's not ordinary. I approached two different friends at two different times, two different locations. Say, you know what, I want to buy a bed. Can you loan me some money? The first one said, my, I can't loan you money, but I'll give you 1,000. He went in and gave me 1,000. So I have 3,500. I traveled, not traveled, but I drove a distance to go and meet the second one. As if though they knew, I mean, that's why I know the spiritual controls the physical. I went to the second one. I told him, this is what I'm going to do. He said, Mike, we are too close. I'm more also, you know me, I've been telling you I don't borrow people money. You know what? My contribution, 1,000. He went in and gave me 1,000. I said, wow, now 4,500. I went to my mom. To cut the loss so short, I was able to make everything 6,000. I said, I'll give to him. I'll pay the rest when I like. And truly speaking, from that single boss, together with my brother, before I closed everything up, we end up with 15 vehicles. 15 vehicles. That in my street like this, both the streets, you see all our vehicles parked both left and right. Glory be to God, glory be to God, glory be to God. That if I walk on the street those times, you see me that some people call me that, and don't let me go that route. Because I was so skinny, and they look at me as if though I'm a millionaire. So what am I saying? It just started because why? I attracted the blessings from that elderly person. So when that seed in you, it will lead you to where and what you need to attract. And many has been channeled to attract curses. In the same book of 2 Kings, when Elisha was coming back, the kids that were playing, they just looked at him. The man was going on his own. How did they see his bald head? I mean, that means the thing in them just turned their face and attracted them to, you know, like a magnet, see his head. And they say, Mr. Bald Head, Mr. Bald. What Elijah did? Nothing. He was just walking by and just looked at them, cursed them. He only cursed. He never called here to come. He never called here to destroy them. But something from somewhere made them to be destroyed by that animal. Just because it says something. So this power is in you, it's in everyone. But we don't know. And because we don't know, that's why we don't know where to go. We don't know where to activate it. Some of us have passed through the blessings. We have passed through our location of blessings. And we don't even know it. That's there. Some of us have passed our future glorious connection. Because we are not sensitive enough to know. But if assuming you knew that power in you was activated for any time, any purpose that is needed, there's nothing that will pass you by. By the time you are seeing it, you know it. You will know that this is this. This is it. Like in Matthew chapter 4, when Jesus Christ was to be baptized. This son is all. In John chapter 1, he also mentioned it. He said, behold, the Savior. Behold, the new. So that thing is there in you and I. But how do we know where to allow it to operate? That's the question. How do I know? I've said earlier on that people who have lived with something for a while, all of a sudden, you just begin to look at that thing with different thoughts. With the demonic thoughts and evil thoughts. Things that have been with you for a while. Something that you have been seeing that you never even pay attention to suddenly just becomes something that is now becoming something like it's trying to be meaningful to you. I never see this thing like this before. Better caution it. I pray for each one today. There will never be a prayer anymore.
Amen.
I say we'll never be a prayer anymore in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We'll never be a prayer anymore in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the same vein, in Acts chapter 3, a man was seated by the gate called Beautiful. And when he saw two people passing by, the Bible says he looked at them in a different way, hoping to get something from them. With different look, hoping to get something from them. And at the end of the day, what happened? He walked out from that place. Just because why? When they were passing by, the place is called the entrance to the church. And it's at the ninth hour of the day. And the ninth hour of the day is a prayer hour. That people from business area all over comes at least to the temple to to key into that prayer hour. So it's not that maybe they are the only one that are passing by this morning. These are the only people that, I mean, the first customer that passed by here. So it's an hour of prayer that people from far and near comes around just to key into it. But when these two people were passing by, the Bible says he fastened his eyes to them, hoping to get something from them. That's a power trigger. Say, look at these people coming. Don't let them pass you by. And when he asked for them, Peter now said, save all gold we have not, but what we have in the name of the Lord Jesus we give unto you. Rise up.
I'm not putting my
hands on you. See, chapter 3. So that power is in you and I. But many has failed to recognize the use of it. Many has failed to know how important it is. A man of God went somewhere and tried to buy land for the church. Somebody told me this story. They were trying to buy a church, build a church land. And while they were going around, they took him to places, beautiful, vast land. But where they got there, the attraction is not there. So he would tell the realtor, no, not this one. They took him to a lot of places. He would say, not this one. Now they took him to one, which is like a dunghill, like him, I mean like a swamp. That is like they were expecting to even say no from afar. But while they were coming down from the car, the realtor said he saw the seriousness in this man moving closer to where he felt would be the first thing to reject. It's like a swamp. And the man was moving closer, moving closer, moving closer. And he got to the point, he said, yes, we found it. He didn't say we found what? He said, I'm attracted to this place. And they say it's a swamp. This one is cheaper than all the lands I've taken you to. Because to build here will cost you more. He said, yes, but I'm attracted to this place. And he bought that land. That even what he paid for, people around are not offering him. Companies are offering him to pay more than 100 times of what he paid for that land. He said, they are not selling. Because the oil there is much on that land. And when they interviewed him, he said he never even knew that something like that was there. If he has knew, the first year they have moved into that place, would have been trying to know they will make money from it. But they've been there for over 7 years before they know. But what just made them to know is a sign of attraction. That when they step on that place, that sign of attraction was there. That he knew that I found what I'm looking for. And I'm standing in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ today to empower every sign of attraction that will bring us to a godly inheritance in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because man, once we have it, we won't make a mistake. We won't choose wrong things. Our wrong desire will not come to stand. Because the moment when the attraction is not there, we'll know that it's not of the Lord. I don't want it. People might be rushing for it. You tell them you don't want it. And that lesson I knew from one of our friends those days. There were two of them, and they were both jobless. After praying for a while, they now decided to go job hunting. So they were going job hunting. So they came to a place. There was a big company. I mean, when you say PLC, you know what I'm talking. Big company on this side. There's a small company on the other side. So people are job hunting. The first thing you imagine is for them to jump in the big one, to jump into the big one. But when this one said, let's pray. We found this big company, we are finding this PLC, we are going there, God grant us favor. The other one said, I'm not attracted to that one. I'm attracted to this small one. The other boy looked at him. You know, in some places when you tell them when you are walking at times, it's a boast to the ego. When you where are you walking? Oh, I walk at the bottom. You say, wow. I walk at Shell, PLC. Oh, wow. Then if you tell them, oh, I work at Access Bank or whatever, I mean, wow, I work at Chevron, wow. But you now tell them you want an Okonkwo Nigeria Limited. But this other boy said, even though this is a big place, but my mind is being attracted to this small one that had a small sign outside there. And the other one said, okay, you know what, you go to that one, I will go to this one. So they both went in. The one that went to a small one was admitted, was employed. So 2 weeks after, the other one was employed in the same big company. So he was now boastful, saying, you see, I told you, if you have come with me, you will both be walking the same place. But he said, I told you I'm not attracted to rich. But guess what? The one that's working in a place like Kankolo, Coco Nigeria Limited, the director will just come home to work one morning. Hey, boy, come. What car do you need to work today? I forgot my boss are there to. You will enter boss to this company? Supervisor, give him a car. So he came home with one car one day. The boy was not like, another time again, don't want to know the end of the year. He said, I have one house in this Jakonde house. It's useless. He called it useless. That I want, that I don't need. He just threw the key to this boy. He just threw the key to this boy. Said, I mean, there's one Jakonde. It's one useless Jakonde. Jakonde. Just threw the key to him. And he said, you go and see if you like it. I'll give you the papers. I'll pay for it. And the boy went and, even though before he get and look at it, if you are the one. It's like, say, Christian, give me something. I say, go and pray about it. This one don't. You quickly, this one is confirmed without prayers. Boy, I came back home that day with a key of the house. And while this one is having a car, having a house, that one is talking of increment salary. That he has to work for 5 years before they increase salary a little bit. And he said, wait a minute. He was not the one asking the other boy later, say, help me ask Oga whether they employ. But the truth of that, the beginning is what matters. It says at the beginning, this is where my mind is being attracted to. And the Bible makes it clear. It says, as many as are led. What does led mean? To be directed. And you can only be directed through this, the power of attraction that you are talking about. He will direct you to where and what belongs to you. And if you know it, you will never be derailed. You will never be cheated. But if you don't let it work, if care is not taken, the devil wants to take advantage of that to know that, oh, I cannot make this one go astray. Let me see if I can put something. I normally pray, priest, he will say attractive bus stop. What does it mean to live in to see attractive bus stop? You are going to somewhere and you saw a bus stop because it's beautiful. That's not your location. You jump down from the car. And if it's then when the our law always come every once a week, and you come down from that one moment, that means that week is gone. So what are we talking tonight? There's something in you that God has given to everybody. It's a seed, and that seed is meant to connect with the heavens, to give you the instruction of where to go, to tell you which one is right for you, to tell you which is not unripe, which is unripe for you. And that way you see it unripe, you don't know, I don't need this. They don't need to, I mean, it's just like, you know, for example, some of you here will tell you, oh, my best color is red. Am I right? Give red to somebody else. What will they tell you? They will say, out of all the colors. You dare not give some people Christmas presents a red color. They will tell you. And even if somebody that does not trust you before, they will tell you the meaning of it. Is it wishing me well or wishing me evil? But to somebody else. So if someone that knows that red is his color, that's what you are attracted to. If they take you to a car dealership, what do they be looking for? Because that's what you are attracted to. That's what your inner man will be attracted to. No matter how you'll be looking for it, I've not found what I'm looking for. Who gave you that thing you are looking for? Who put it in you? It's not you. You didn't make it yourself. You didn't design right in your heart. You didn't make your heart to be looking for something red. But something in you that has been planted as a seed in you, that's the code that's given to that. And because you don't know it, we don't allow it to function. That's why you see some couple in a trickle of a while. They marry in 2 hours with $3 million ring, only for 72 hours. and all is over. Something different, something negative happened that way. But you and I, as children of God, we are meant to embrace this power. We are meant to make use of this positive, attractive seed that is in us. That when we find ourselves anywhere, we don't even need anybody to decide for us. We know that something in us will tell us what is for us. And I'm praying that we'll get there in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That even if they present it to you, you will know, no, this is not mine. This, I'm not more than this. This is not what belongs to me. No, I'm still here to get mine. They'll be wondering, what are you there waiting for? I'm waiting for that which is mine. They will know you know what is yours. And I'm praying tonight in the name of the Lord Jesus that dwells in heaven. Everything that belongs to God, our heart will keep with it.
Amen.
Our understanding will be open.
Amen.
And will not pass us by in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And so shall it be to the glory of the heavens.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
What about Luke chapter 19? It was a short man, Zacchaeus. But when he heard that Jesus was passing by, something in him was like, I need to see this man. I need to see him. The Bible says, now make effort to try to see him. Because he was short of a short stature, he could not see him. What did he now do? He went and climbed on the tree. Just to fulfill that desire to see him. And guess what? He's not the only one that saw Christ. But when Christ looked at that and saw him, he said, Zacchaeus, come down. For today, I'm going to your house. Today, I'm going to your house. Which would not have happened. But something in him was being stirred up. Saying, I need to see this person. I need to see him. I need to see. And that's what brought Jesus to his home. There are other disciples there that the Bible never recorded that Jesus Christ went to their home. But somebody was, he was even a sinner as being called. A tax collector for that matter. Something he was able to bring Jesus to his house. Also in Matthew chapter 8. In Matthew chapter 8, there's a story that was recorded that they saw Jesus and they said, no. If this man will, he can heal us. Something in them was telling them that Jesus can heal us. Jesus can perform this healing. And they cried, if thou will, you can make us clean. If thou will, how did they know? But something in them is telling, this man can make you whole. Don't let him go. If thou will, that can make me whole. And Jesus Christ made them whole. So in a nutshell tonight, you have that power in you. I have that seed in me. You have that seed in you. But do we recognize it? Do we activate it? Do we challenge it to work? That from this day, you must connect me to my greatness. I'm believing God that you'll be able to work rightly from now. That even if you want to knock any wrong door, it will just swell up to let you know that, no, don't do it. No, don't do it. No, don't do it. You will know that this is not mine. I can't do this. Then if you get that sign and you back out, what happened then? You will never be a victim behind the enemy anymore. So that's where we are going. I pray we shall get more understanding in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Any contribution or question? Can you give me some minutes more? Yes, ma'am.
I'm grateful for the power. Thank you for the negative attraction was what caused Lot's doom. Because when Abraham called him, when there was strife between the two servants, Abraham called him and said, okay, there is Jews. As somebody being an uncle to you, I think you would have told him that, uncle, you just give me one place to go. But instead, when he saw the land of Sodom,
grass.
he was attracted to it, not knowing that there is doom there. So this negative attraction caused his doom. Then when we look at the life of David too, when he saw Bathsheba, instead of taking off
his eyes,
he was attracted, and this one caused him problem into that milk. God to say sword will continue in this tribe. So from what we learned today, I think we need the grace of God and power of God so that we will not be attracted to negative things.
Amen. God bless you. Amen. Amen. That is true, because when David, that's why at the end of the story, David said, I've made a covenant with my eyes. No more sleeping, no more looking at the things that are not worthy. Because when that happens to him, and the king and Nathan came to tell him his story, he said, who is that person? Let him be slain. Under my kingdom, he will be killed. Do not say, oh, you are the one. You are the one. Yes, sir.
Praise the Lord. You know, most times you see young people that
he's talking because he's old now.
Young people. I'm looking at it from my age down, not up. Okay, we young people. Okay, we young people. That sometimes we both youthful, exuberant, both looking at things that, hey, we are in a modern age. This is nice. This is beautiful. You know, and they just go based on what they see. You know, God in it is not the issue. This is good, and we are going for it. But that God is leading them, or something is attracting them to that. No, that is not a question. My question is, how, if you, for those that have gone through it once and they've got their hand bumped, but they've not dealt with it in the past, how can they deal with, you know, getting attracted negative, getting attracted to things they are not supposed to be attracted to?
Anybody want to answer us?
Can you rephrase the question?
How can you, if you have, say, once beaten, say you have been a victim in the first state, how can you prevent from such from happening again, Marisa? How can you prevent such reoccurrence? Affliction shall not arise second time. How can you prevent it? Yes, sir.
What I mean by that is that, yes, it has happened, that you see the negative effect, but you never dealt with it. You didn't know how to deal with it. Another thing is confronting you now. You are still going that direction. How can you, you know, deal with such, you know, getting attracted negative?
If you have something like that, you don't have to get it yourself. Either you need the man of God, or you need somebody that has passed through that experience. You see it out. Don't keep it to yourself. If you keep it to yourself, you're not going to be able to deal with that question, with that issue. So you have to meet somebody that have dealt with your question, or rather, that has sense of humor, that understand that thing. Because let me use for instance, like we always say foundation. By my opinion, you can't deal with your foundation yourself. You get what I'm saying? It's like I'm you can't deal with your foundation yourself. Either you need a man of God, or you need somebody that has dealt with all his own foundation that can help you out. Because foundation is not what you can bring yourself out of it. The question he asks is that you need somebody that.
Yes, sir.
Okay, can you hear elaborate on the power of attraction so I can have a better understanding?
The power of attraction is something that gets you attracted either to good things or bad things. It can attract you to good things, it can attract you to bad things. So you have to know how to be able to stop yourself when that power is drawing you to what is wrong or what is not right. But that same power can bring you to a better place, a good place, by allowing God to lead you. That's the summary of the whole thing. You okay, man? Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir.
Praise the Lord. The book of Proverbs 4:7 says, wisdom is the principal thing. And if you lack wisdom, you need to go to God. God is the only one that can give wisdom. So if you have gone through something once, you get burnt. And then you're going through the same route again. It means you have not gotten wisdom. And the only person that can help you is to turn to your God and ask God for wisdom, because such person lack wisdom and understanding. If you can get wisdom, God says, if you lack wisdom, ask, I will give it to you. So because you have not, because you have not asked. If you ask, the Lord will give it up to you. So it is wisdom that it takes for you to know, to discern between wrong and right. If you don't possess the wisdom and the understanding, you find yourself doing the same thing over and over, expecting a different result.
God bless you, sir.
Yes, sir.
Praise the Lord. Well, I think my understanding of his question leads more towards addiction, though, in the sense of which I know I've had, like, and since he said the younger generation, which I fall into, thank God for that. I've had like cases where people talk about, oh, I fall into a certain sin. I go to the altar, ask for forgiveness, do it several times to the point where I'm even tired. I don't think God's going to forgive me anymore. So when I hear things like that, it doesn't sound as if they don't, it's not as if they haven't prayed about it. Now, I don't know how they prayed about it, how they addressed it. I don't think, I don't want to say they're not wise either, because I know for them to actively keep praying, going back and asking, they know that they really want to get delivered from it, but they keep going back to it. That's my understanding of the question. So for me, like, I do lean towards what he said in a little bit of, first of all, there's the spiritual aspect to it, and then there's the environmental aspect to it as well. So if you smoke, and you want to quit smoking, and you keep hanging out with people who smoke, you're going to go back into smoking, no matter how much you pray and fast about it. If you keep putting yourself in the environment, if it's someone who puts on the computer watching porn, if you stay up late at night on the computer, it's going to happen. No matter how prayerful you are, if you keep like giving yourself environments like that. So I think there's, of course, the spiritual part. I like how that talked about the wisdom to it as well. The wisdom would also apply when it comes to reaching out. If I reach out to somebody here because I feel he or she is overly spiritual, oh, I have issues with pornography, and next thing I know, he's preaching about me and referring to me, like I can't get delivered from it because now I'm completely shut down. So you also have to apply wisdom to who you're reaching out to help you with stuff like that. And comes down to exposure as well. Whether we like it or not, darkness is the best way for sin to thrive. When you hide it, when you say, I'm not telling anybody, it will thrive. No matter how hard it is, you'll be like, oh, I can control it. I have that. I'm a biology major. Serotonin, that is something that the human body has been built to handle. Whenever those hormones start getting released, like you talked about Samson, the environment is different. It becomes stupid. You do things that when you're normal, you would think it's dumb. But the moment you're exposed to the appropriate emotions, those hormones come in, to you it's just like, oh, I'm just going to let it pass through. So for me, the combination is first things first, spiritual part you can never take out of it. Prayer, most people already have that because they are asking for it, they are having that drive. Second part, of course, is the wisdom to know the appropriate person to reach out to if need be. And third, of course, is try as much as possible to avoid the environments that stimulate it.
God bless you, sir. It's well. Okay.
Praise the Lord. I have a question.
Let me put the understanding that I want to, everything that was said is perfect. But just one more thing that I'm expected to hear is the truth. The prodigal son found his hand bonds when he took the father's money and went away. And the only way he knew he can help himself, the Bible says in Luke 15:17, and when he came to himself, he tell himself the truth. You have to get to a point where you can tell yourself the truth. If you tell yourself the truth, you'll be able to filter out which of my friend will not help me. Which of the place will not help me. No, what am I doing that's causing all this?
I was telling her sometimes, if you watch all these small girls that get pregnant, and they would, you hear them each time, they say, it's not true. I didn't know that time because I was drunk. Yeah, many of them say they are drunk. If you want to tell yourself the truth, you know, this is what is killing me. From this day, I don't want to go near. So in conclusion, in addition to what they have said, you must get to a point where you must tell yourself the truth. And the truth will help you. Yes, ma'am.
Praise the Lord. Okay, my question is, for Christians, when they get attracted to negative things, they have the opportunity to go to God and, you know, ask God for wisdom. But my question is this, how do you cancel non-Christians when they get attracted to negative things and they are going through trials?
How do you cancel non-Christian? Convert them to the Christian.
We know.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. You know, first of all, for them to come to you, they've seen, they've observed you from afar, and they feel that there's something different about you. And in that state is to explain the difference, what makes the difference in your life to them, because there's no other thing you can offer to them. You know, what they expect you is still, it's going to be all right, just hang in there, nothing, you know, keep living your life. I tell them, they come to me, the one will go to medical, will tell him, man, you're going to die if you keep smoking. They'll say, I don't know what I'm going to do. Man, they say, stop smoking. And I'll see them the next day, they are out there smoking. I say, you are smoking again. He says, I'm just one or two. There's no way I can just encourage them. At times, you know, when I came to America, I discovered that some of these things in America, they don't tell them the truth. They manage it. There's a lot of management of things that if you have told somebody the truth, that thing will have been over. When we are in the military, they talk about suicide prevention a lot, but they don't talk about the sanctity of life. I was in a training and I said, what are you guys doing? Have you ever educated them that life is the most precious thing that you have? If you lose it, you have lost everything. No. They said, when you notice that somebody is suicidal, okay, just, you know, report it, you know, and all that thing. Good. You can do all that. But the truth still remains that life, you know, is the best that you have. That is not said. It's just you seek treatment, go here, and that's it. And in the medical world, people are making money. They are loving it, you know. So how to counsel them is what you have, what you know. At times, you're not a counselor, you are not trained in counselor. I say, hey, this is what I can offer you. If you want more, you can go to a counselor, but this is the starting point for me. Use your life as, you know, as a bait for, you know, talking to them.
Praise the Lord. The best bet to raise is that before you talk to God about man, talk to God about that man. Before you talk to man about God, talk to God about that man first. And John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world, and he gave his only begotten Son to do what again? And whosoever believeth on him shall be saved. If the Spirit of God is not in the mind of anybody at that time, it's difficult for you to even cancel anybody right. Because it says the ways of salvation is like a foolishness. So when you are talking about, they'll not be looking at it, you old school. You don't know what you are talking about. Because at that time, it's still foolishness to them. But when you are able to talk to God about them, when you are now talking to them about God, about the right thing, there will be little hearing here that will make them to hear. And once they're able to hear, you have sowed the seed in them that even if they leave your house, they leave your presence, it might continue to echo. Because what Jesus Christ, what the Bible says in Matthew 24, verse 14, it says that this gospel shall be preached all over the world as a witness. It's not saying they will change. As a witness, they might change, they might not be changed. It's after they have started, hear it as a witness, then the end will come. So yours just to plant that seed. And if you talk to God, just a moment, a minute, even if it costs you from two, God, I thank you. You're just like, just take hand go back to God and leave the rest. By the time you want to talk to him, God will pick it up from there. Praise the Lord. Shall we all rise where we give God the... You might have a question? Okay, sir. I want to come back again. Answer your question.
No,
I'm not going out. Answer your question.
I was actually going to respond.
Okay, respond. It's when you tell the Bible study, you might tell me, I won't let you preach on that quit again for Bible study.
Then you will transfer me for good.
Lord, there.
Praise the Lord. For an unbeliever to come to you, a believer, is because that they've seen some sort of light in you. And it could be, just like Pastor said, like Nehemiah did when he was approaching the king, when the question is asked, he quickly speak to God. If it is something that happens impromptu, you can just close your eyes momentarily and speak to God. God, show me the way to direct this person. Maybe God is sending that person to you at that moment to be able to get them out of darkness into his marvelous light. Maybe a word that God will give to you that you will speak to that individual at that moment will bring them from their darkness into the light. So probably in a situation like that, let's always look at that God is sending that person your way for a purpose, for you to be able to convert them over and to win them over to God's side.